A 12-year-old African-American girl says that her classmates called her hair ugly and nappy as they pinned her down and cut several of her dreadlocks.
CNN's Rene Marsh spoke to Amari Allen and her family about what happened.
12-year-old sixth grader Amari Allen is healing after she says three white male classmates at Emmanuel Christian School in Springfield, Virginia, targeted and attacked her because of her hair.
I was about to go down one of the slides when three boys came up to me, like surrounded me, and they put me on the ground. One of them put my hands behind my back, one put their hands over my mouth, and one cut my hair.
The alleged attack on school grounds was both physical and verbal.
They were saying, like, my hair was ugly, it was nappy. They were saying that I don't deserve to live, I shouldn't have been born.
The back of it was in the middle of her back, and they cut all of these.
Her grandmother says she was targeted for being different.
They attacked her as whom God created her to be, as a young lady of color.
Amari says it was the school bell that saved her. When it rang,
we ran off laughing, went back to the line, and I just got myself up and went back to the line.
It started the first day of school when they start taking her lunch and eating her lunch in front of her, telling her these nasty words, you're not fit to live. You're not fit to live. You're ugly. Your hair is nappy. You don't belong here.
The school told CNN in a statement, "We take seriously the emotional and physical well-being of all of our students and have a zero-tolerance policy for any kind of bullying or abuse. The student body there is 52% white and 11% African-American." Emmanuel Christian made news earlier this year because Second Lady Karen Pence teaches art part-time there, despite a school policy that bans gay students and parents. Pence's office defended her decision to work there. The Allen family filed a police report, and the Fairfax County Police Department tells CNN they are now investigating.
You realize that you are beautiful, right?
Yes.
And you realize that your hair is beautiful too, right?
Right.
In the meantime, Amari's family says they are reminding her daily that she is enough, trying to reverse the negative impact of the painful words from her classmates.
We used to say sticks and stones will break my bones, but words will never hurt. Words will kill. It's a lot of people today that have committed suicide over one word. So words have deep scarring.
Well, Amari missed a few days of school as a result of this incident, but she plans to return. And the school told CNN those involved in the incident will be out of school while police continue their investigation. Now, the family says that they do forgive these students, but they want to see them receive some sort of punishment and counseling so that they never do this to anyone else again. Rene Marsh, CNN, Washington.